We want to find all these solutions to cosine 7x minus cosine 3x equals sine 5x on the given interval, where the interval is closed on 0 and open on pi radians. To begin, we'll rewrite the left side of the equation, or this difference here, as a product using the given sum to product identity, where we have cosine A minus cosine B is equal to this product on the right. Notice in our case, A is equal to 7x and B is equal to 3x, which means the left side of this equation can be written as negative 2 times sine of A plus B divided by 2 would be 7x plus 3x divided by 2, which would be 10x divided by 2, or 5x, times sine of the quantity A minus B divided by 2, which would be 7x minus 3x, that's 4x, divided by 2, or 2x. So we have the left side written as this product must equal sine 5x. Now at this point, we do have to be careful. It might be tempting to divide out sine 5x, but if we do that, we'll lose some of these solutions. Instead, we'll set this equal to 0 and factor to solve. So we're going to subtract sine 5x on both sides of the equation, which would give us negative 2 sine 5x times sine 2x. And again, subtracting sine 5x on both sides, we'd have minus sine 5x equals 0. Notice how we have a common factor of sine 5x, but we also have a negative sign here and a minus sign here. So let's go ahead and factor out negative sine 5x. If we factor out negative sine 5x, that will leave us with positive 2 sine 2x, and then plus 1. If we factor out negative sine 5x from this term here, we're left with plus 1. And now if this product equals 0, then either negative sine 5x equals 0, or 2 times sine 2x plus 1 equals 0. For this equation, if we divide both sides by negative 1, we just have sine 5x equals 0. Here to solve for sine 2x, we would subtract 1 on both sides and then divide by 2, which would give us sine 2x equals negative 1/2. Now we need to find all the angles that satisfy these two equations on this given interval. Let's go ahead and do that on the next slide. To help us solve this first equation, let's perform a substitution. Let's let 5x equal theta. Therefore, we can solve the equation sine theta equals 0. We have to keep in mind, though, that if 5x equals theta, then x is equal to theta divided by 5. So we have to find all the angles for theta such that x equals theta divided by 5 would be in this interval here. So if we go to the unit circle, remember sine theta equals y, so sine theta would be 0 here at 0 radians, then again at pi radians, then at 2 pi radians, 3 pi radians, 4 pi radians, and so on. So we can say in terms of theta, the solutions would be theta equals 0 radians, pi radians, 2 pi radians, 3 pi radians, and so on. Now again, the reason why we're going past pi radians is because remember, x is equal to theta divided by 5, and our goal is to solve this for x, not theta. So if these are the solutions for theta, then x would be equal to these solutions divided by 5. So 0 divided by 5 is still 0. Pi divided by 5 would be pi divided by 5, or 1/5 pi. If theta equals 2 pi, x equals 2 pi divided by 5. Notice all these solutions are on the interval from 0 to pi. So next we'd have 3 pi divided by 5, then 4 pi divided by 5. But notice when theta is 5 pi radians, x would be just pi, and this interval does not include pi. So here are five solutions in terms of x. And now let's use the same strategy on this next equation. Let's perform a substitution and let 2x equal theta. So if 2x equals theta, then we can solve the equation sine theta equals -1/2, as long as we keep in mind that if 2x equals theta, then x is equal to theta divided by 2. So now let's go back to the unit circle and find some solutions in terms of theta, and then we'll find x. We'll notice that sine theta equals -1/2 here in the third quadrant and here in the fourth quadrant. So theta would be equal to 7 pi divided by 6 plus multiples of 2 pi, or 11 pi divided by 6 plus multiples of 2 pi. So let's go ahead and begin with 7 pi divided by 6. The next angle would be this plus 2 pi, or 12 pi divided by 6, which would be 19 pi divided by 6, and so on. And then if we use the angle theta, 11 pi divided by 6, once again we could add multiples of 2 pi, or add 12 pi divided by 6, which would be 23 pi divided by 6. Now remember, our goal here is to find x, or the values that satisfy the equation on this interval here. Here we wrote x equals theta divided by 2, but because theta is already a fraction, we could write this as 1/2 times theta. So if theta is equal to 7 pi divided by 6, if we multiply this by 1/2, that would be 7 pi divided by 12, which is in the given interval. But notice how the next angle in this list would not be. So let's go to the second list for theta. 11 pi divided by 6 times 1/2, that would be 11 pi divided by 12, which is less than pi radians. We can go ahead and ignore this last angle, because 1/2 times 23 pi over 6 would be greater than pi. So we found two more solutions from this equation for x on this given interval. I hope you found this explanation helpful.